two, three, four.
Welcome to the first edition of WPRP. I'm Katie.
And I'm Drew. We've been in school for almost 6 weeks now, but some students will never forget the summer of 2013.
Mr. Doty took some PRP students to a place they'll never forget.
Have everyone to take a trip, not just across the bridge, but someplace really far away, with some of our fellow students did that just this summer.
Mr. Doty and a group of 9 PRP students packed their bags for a once-in-a-lifetime world tour. The group traveled to Europe and explored several different countries.
The trip that I took with students was around $3,000. The trip that we've just taken this last summer was right at $3,800, but was nearly twice as long as our original trip. Some of the students paid for it themselves. Some of the students got help from family and friends. Some of the students used fundraisers to pay for most of it. Others got part-time jobs to pay for it.
The trip didn't come cheap. Students had to dig deep to pay for their adventure, but most say it was all worth it.
I mean, I paid for the whole thing myself, but I just sold donuts and candy every day.
This year I took 9 PRP students with me, and there were 13 of us total. I had one adult and then her daughter. We usually go every year. The type of trip depends on what the students who are wanting to go communicate to me, and then we choose a trip based on that.
It was my first time going on a plane, so it's kind of scary, but eventually, you know, you get used to it because you ride 4 of them, but it was very interesting.
This trip wasn't just one-stop shop. After a 9-hour flight to Germany, the students were off on their European vacation.
The longest flight was from Detroit to Germany. It was about 9 hours long. But about 2 hours into it, I just got really bored and I was really tired and just ready to get there. Oh, besides the plane, we went on a train, a metro. We took a bus throughout most of the countries except London, but we used the metro a lot, which was pretty kind of scary because I thought I was going to get left behind and almost did once.
We went to Italy, France, Germany, Switzerland, the UK, and Austria. Most of the kids there speak multiple languages. Like, every country speaks English, and they also speak, like in Switzerland, they can speak up to 4 languages.
The most I'm going to remember is when we went on the Eiffel Tower, because it was really pretty when we were up there, even though it took a while to get up there, because we had to walk the first 2 flights, and it was tiring, but overall it was really fun. And I'm not going to forget about the different types of food they had over there, because it was really different than what we eat.
On that, and we've started doing our trips usually in the summer, because we can make them a little bit longer. And it's more cost effective for us because we get to spend more time in Europe and see more countries. We have a 2014 trip where we'll be going to Amsterdam and then Germany and then Italy and Switzerland, then over to Paris and then up to London. It's a 15-day tour and we are leaving at the beginning of July, I believe.
If you are not one of the lucky 9 on this trip, start saving up now. Mr. Doty is already planning next summer's trip.
If you want more information, go see Mr. Doty in room 212.
I'm glad all the students had fun. Why don't you start saving up and join them on the 2014 trip?
Now that we're back in school, everyone needs to be working hard to keep good grades and work on your GPA.
Here's Caitlin with more information.
College is a place where dreams and goals are pursued, and having the right GPA will get you there.
GPA, your grade point average, is very important because it helps you to earn money toward college. A savings account. And when people say, well, you don't pay me to go to school, they are totally wrong because for every A that you get, you are earning money. For every B, if you have a 2.5, which is a C plus average, B minus average, then you can accumulate money starting at a 2.5. And there are 2 things when you apply to colleges that they look at. One is your ACT score, and the other is your GPA. If you're planning on transitioning after high school to college, that GPA will be a gatekeeper. And if you've got that good solid GPA, it's going to open that gate to college.
Thanks, Caitlin.
Didn't you talk to some seniors?
Yes, I did.
Let's see what the seniors have to say about the volleyball team this year.
This year's volleyball team is led by six seniors: Katie Laughlin, Elaine Russell, Caitlin Clark, Caitlin Wathen, Amanda Malakas, and Bree Jaggers. We spoke to Amanda Malakas and Katie Laughlin about being part of the volleyball team this year as a senior.
I think volleyball's going really good because we're coming together as a team and we're learning how to work together more and we're communicating and we're having a lot of fun this season.
I love my team, and I hope I can get the girls ready for next season.
We all want to say good luck to the volleyball girls as they work hard towards districts.
Good luck, ladies, in the rest of your season. And one last good luck to the football team next week at the homecoming.
Signing off for WPRP, I'm Katie.
And I'm Drew. Have a great rest of the day. Dude, sit.
And make sure we're evening.